In this GIMP workshop, we're going to make a rectangle speech bubble with rounded corners. If you want to follow along, the download link for the image is in the video description. When we've opened our image, we will start by making a new layer. Press Ctrl-Shift-N on your keyboard to make a new layer. Fill in the name Speech Balloon. Make sure that the layer fill type is transparency and click OK. Press the R key to make the rectangle select tool active. Check the option Rounded Corners. Now click and drag a rectangle shape where you want to make your text balloon. At the rounded corner radius, we triple click on the figures and type in 70, and then we press Enter on our keyboard. Then we go to the toolbox and click on the Paths tool. Click 3 points to make a triangle as shown in the video, and then hover over the first point. Press the Ctrl key, and when we see the Connect Chain icon, we click to close the path. Now we can, by click and drag on the lines, bend both lines a bit to make a nice curve. Press and hold the Shift key, and click on the button Selection from Path. Click and drag the white background color to the selection to fill it with the color white. Then we go to the menu bar, hit Select, and then click To Path. Now click in the tool options on the button Stroke Path. Make the line width 15 and click Stroke. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect the selection and press the T key to make the text tool active. The path is now invisible. Triple click on the font name and rename it Martina. Hit the Tab key and change the size to 50. Then drag out the text framework where you want to place your text. Type in, "Hey Teddy, pay attention now." Place the cursor without clicking on top of the font icon and roll the mouse wheel so you can see different fonts pass by. This is an easy way to choose your font. Then we triple click in the text to select it and adjust its size with the little triangles in the dialog box. Click again in the text to deselect it. Now we can place our text in its proper position by moving the corners and/or the handles of the framework. When we do this, we must be aware that the top left corner in the framework is the anchor point of the text. When all this is done, we go to Image in the menu bar and click Flatten Image. And there it is, a rectangle text balloon with rounded corners. I hope this helps a little. And if so, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a nice comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.